नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। I welcome all of you with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, srimahans, mahans, kotaris, tanedars, sitting with us through Nityananda TV, Sadhana TV, Ara TV, and two-way video conferencing, having Nayanadiksha all over the world. The city is sitting with us through two-way video conferencing, having Nayanadiksha, Hong Kong, Sirgali, Torrance, Trinidad, Indrani, New Jersey, Hyderabad, Guptakashi, Guadalupe, Hollywood, Satsang Center, Warrington, UK, Vancouver, Singapore, Huzur, Oklahoma, Dubai, Rajapalayam, Bangalore North, Ohio Prayag, Los Angeles, Kuala Lumpur Palani, Chennai, Toronto, San Jose, Melbourne, Seattle, St. Louis, Oman, Phoenix, and some more cities. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. I'll continue on the 8th verse of Upanishads, the Isavasya Upanishad. Saparyaka Chukram Akayam Avranam Asnaviram Sudamapabhaviddam Kavir Manishi Paribhu Swayambhur Yata Tat Yato Arthan Vyadadascha Chashvadibhyaha Samabhyaha. Pure consciousness is all pervasive, like space beyond the coming and going, absolute, radiant and effulgent, unembodied, boundaryless whole, beyond the subtle body, woundless, muscleless, having no incompletion with the body, beyond the grass body, consciousness is the ever pure space, devoid of the dirt of ignorance, beyond the causal body, and is untouched by the delusion of incompletion. Consciousness is the all-knowing seer of all, past, present and future. The Lord of all minds, consciousness transcends all beings. Consciousness is self-existent by itself, with its independent will and intelligence, having no cause for its happening. It is pure consciousness that from time eternal has enriched the ages and each being by ordaining desirable responsibilities unto them as per their nature and space and their actions and results thereof. Now listen. I wanted every one of you to align your cognition about you, your concept about you, to these definitions of Upanishad. Please understand, who is Hindu? I am defining as an incarnation as per Hinduism, as an incarnation as per Vedic tradition. I am defining who is Hindu. Whoever is already cognized themselves as per the Upanishad, this Isavasya Upanishad verse, or working towards altering their cognition as Upanishad describes about them. Please understand, I am defining who is Hindu. Either you should have already cognized yourself as Upanishad declares you, or you should be working to cognize yourself as Upanishad declares you. Only then you are a Hindu. Whoever does this is a Hindu. Understand? The religions which wanted number to be their priority, which are used for political power or a power game on the society, they all give the right just by birth you belong to that religion. But the Vedic tradition, Hindu tradition, we never used our religion for political power. We will never use our religion for political power. This is the pure spiritual tradition. I wanted to tell Hindus, never allow anybody to use our religion for political power. Let's be very clear. This religion is a spiritual tradition, and it will continue to remain as a spiritual tradition. It will retain its purity. We never declare just by birth somebody is Hindu. Only by practicing you become Hindu. Only by practicing you belong to Vedic tradition. This gives one more freedom. You don't need to be born to be Hindu. Birth is not a prerequisite. Understand? Neither birth is a prerequisite, nor just birth makes you a Hindu. Whoever cognizes themselves as consciousness, as Upanishads declare in this verse, they are Hindus. Whoever is trying to cognize themselves as Upanishads declare in this verse, they are Hindus. Today's subject for Vakyartha Sadas is how each one of us can raise our cognition about ourselves as Hindu, by cognizing ourself as consciousness as Upanishads describe, as Upanishads declare. The first word, pure consciousness, is all pervasive, beyond the coming and going. Come on, now, whatever pattern you have which denies this belief that you are all pervasive beyond coming and going, pin down all those patterns, start digging out. Let's start working on completion. Listen. The second point, absolute radiant and self effulgent, swayam prakasa, and absolutely powerful, absolutely alive and exciting. I am telling you, just before starting the satsang, when Nityananda Times video was going on, I called Jnanatma and told, play the recorded satsang. I don't think I'll be able to sit now. I just feel like resting the body into samadhi. And actually, I'm working on a very important project of taking out all the initiations as described by Mahadeva without missing a single word, aligning them into our initiations, into our programs, and something more. Little larger level project. Every word we are uttering in NDY, Nitya Dhyan Yoga, Nitya Kriya Yoga, Inner Awakening, every word taught to you in those programs. I wanted two things. One, it should be directly referred, quoted from the Upanishad and directly scientifically validated. This two qualification has to be there for every word uttered in Inner Awakening program or every word uttered in NDY program, every word uttered in NKY program. If an Acharya or me, if we make a statement, you are consciousness, I should validate that from Shastra and science. If I am uttering a word, this meditation awakens your Kundalini Shakti, opens your root chakra, this should be validated as per Shastra and the science. Of course, naturally I am designing everything as per my experience. It is already validated by my experience. But I am doing this project of validation by Shastra, validation by the ancient Shastras and modern day Shastras, both. Eastern science and Western science, both. So, I'm preparing the body with deep samadhi so that all these informations can be downloaded and aligned. So just before the satsang, I told Jnanatma, I don't think I'll be able to sit for the whole satsang. Body feels like resting into samadhi. Please play that recorded discourse. But the moment I saw the Upanishad word, absolute radiant, I said, come on, I am doing the satsang. You don't need to play. No, I wanted to convey, even just remembering absolute radiant, you are there radiating. Please understand, radiant is not just you radiating inside samadhi, constantly making the people that you are radiating. Please understand, even if I am resting in samadhi, I will be radiating. But that is not radiant. Radiant means people should experience you are radiant. An enlightened being can afford to be radiating in samadhi in a cave all by himself. An incarnation can't afford that. For an incarnation, people should experience you are radiating, because that is the purpose I assumed this body. not for me to just reside in samadhi. For that, I don't even need to assume the body. I can just be there in the Kailasa, the space of radiating super consciousness. But I assumed the body for people to experience that consciousness is radiant, absolute radiant. The moment I read that word, absolute radiant, I said, come on, I can't afford to be radiating within me. I should see to it. People experience that consciousness is radiant. So now set the second statement, absolute radiant and self-effulgent. So this is what is supposed to be your cognition about you. Whatever is denying this cognition, what all the other cognitions you are carrying other than this, what all cognitions are denying you being absolute, radiant and self-effulgent, pin down them. Let's find the root of those patterns. Don't worry. Oh, if I make the list of all the descriptions as per Upanishad, I may have 25,000 patterns, I can publish a book on it. No, don't worry, it is not true. The cotton bags may look 10,000, but you don't have to burn one by one, each one of them. No, just put one matchstick. The whole thing will be burnt. Just because, oh, 10,000 cotton gunny bags are there, how will I be able to burn them one by one? Even if I use my hand and throw, how will I use each gunny bag? I have to throw 100 times. And 10,000 gunny bags are there. How will I throw? When will I burn? Just put one match stick, burning match stick, over. Same way, sit and pen down. After penning down 10-20 patterns, suddenly you will realize it all boils down to one pattern. And suddenly you will realize that pattern also boils down to one ignorance. Suddenly you will realize that one ignorance need to be completed only with one concept. That suddenly you will realize that concept also does not have so much have power over you. You are already powerful. And suddenly you will realize, not only you are enlightened now, you are enlightened forever. I tell you, it is just digging that makes things happen. Manana makes enlightenment happen. Just internalizing makes enlightenment happen. Manana makes enlightenment happen. Listen. It is manana that makes enlightenment happen. Next few days, I wanted every one of you to do this homework. This will be the subject of the Vakyartha Sadas. Topic by topic you will pick up. Pure consciousness is all pervasive beyond the coming and going. So this should be my cognition. What else do I have as my experience about me? Other than this, what is the cognition I am carrying about me? Where am I denying my existence as Upanishads declares me? Please understand, beyond coming and going means birthless, deathless. Birthless, deathless. You don't come to some place and go away from that place. So what is it which is constantly making you believe you come and go? What is the pattern you need to complete to realize that you are beyond coming and going? Sit and list those patterns. I wanted the Vakyartha Sadas to be happening today on this subject. Each one should dig out the pattern you are having which makes you believe other than what Upanishads declare you as you. Upanishads are saying you are all pervasive. You are pure consciousness. You are beyond coming and going. You neither come nor go. You are beyond that. Then what is that makes me believe I come, I go? Pen down those patterns. Discuss about those patterns. And tomorrow, you can take up the next definition. Absolute, radiant and self-effulgent. I am absolute, radiant and self-effulgent means Swayam Prakasa, self-shining. Nothing else need to glorify me or give me joy, give me bliss, give me excitement. If I am having an idea, something else can give me pleasure. Something else can make me self-effulgent, exciting. That is the wrong pattern. What is it that gives me that wrong belief? I am a self-excited, self-inspired, self-energetic, self-radiant, self-bliss, self-joy being. If I have some other concept, cognition, what is it? Dig out and pen down. Let's work on this Upanishad. Isavasya Upanishad's 8th verse, one by one. You will see suddenly in 3-4 days, as I described beautifully, you will understand. Millions of incompletions merging into one or two patterns, the one or two patterns merging into one or two ignorance, that one ignorance merging into one powerlessness suddenly disappearing into powerfulness. So internalizing itself leading you to liberation. I tell you, any intelligent man will understand. Many times, even if you internalize and intranalyze your problem, you will find a solution. And then you will have only one fear. Will I remember this solution forever, or will I forget this again and be in the same ditch? Don't worry. How many times you fall into the ditch, more number of times I will raise you out of the ditch. Fight. It's a challenge between you and me. You go on declaring, no, I will fall. I will go on declaring, I will get you out. Don't worry about that. And one more thing. After some time, you will be tired of falling. I will not be tired of rising. Understand? You will be tired of falling, but I will not be tired of rising. So that is the hope and assurance you have. Don't worry about, oh, I may fall down again. No. You have somebody tirelessly raising you up. So you don't need to worry. And any number of times you may fall, at one time you have to become tired of falling. But you have a person who raises you, who can never become tired of raising. So you have that assurance. Don't worry. You can see in your life, many times when you intra-analyze, suddenly the problem disappears and you have a solution. That same technology, now I am using it to help you to realize even the ultimate problem can be solved. Ultimate truth can be realized. I don't want to go to the next lines, next verses. The next verses are unembodied, boundaryless, whole, woundless, muzzleless, no incompletion. We will go into all this after you finish the basic homework of this first two definitions. Because I wanted the Upanishads to become a realization. And I also wanted to tell you all, I'll speak on Kathopanishad, but I don't think I'll be able to complete Kathopanishad within the 21 days. Of Varanasi Inner Awakening, I'll start on Kathopanishad, because Kathopanishad has too many slokas. In the 21 days, I may introduce Kathopanishad. I'm not an expert like people who speak on full Upanishad in 2-3 days, and people who speak on Bhagavad Gita 3-4 days, I'm not that expert. I'm a village boy. I'll have to take you step by step. And I am very sure, and I am very clear, I wanted to speak on Upanishads to make this as your experience, not just to prove I also can speak on Upanishads. Please understand, I picked up Upanishads to speak on it, to make it as your experience. Not to prove, I can also speak on Upanishads. Let me be very clear. So, I wanted every one of you to do this as a homework for next few days. I bless you all. Let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Advaita, the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.
நித்யானந்த தியான பீட்டம், நித்யானந்த நகர், ஆஃப் மைசூர் ரோட், பிடதி, பெங்களூரு. ஃபோன் 08027279999. www.nityananda.org www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.